get your coffee? Do you have a preference?
I like a latte, but...
All right.
It's not uncommon to find Republican Jim Burkey and Democrat Jeff Walz walking together. But what's turning some heads is that they're also running together for the same seat in Congress.
We're showing people through this effort, whether Jim wins or whether I win, that we can discuss the issues in a civil way.
The candidates have crossed party lines to merge their campaigns in an attempt to unseat one of the most powerful men in Washington, 15-term Congressman Jim Sensenbrenner. The Republican and the Democrat figure the best way to do that is to do it together.
Representative Sensenbrenner is part of a Congress, both Democratic and Republican, that simply has failed to talk civilly about important issues and get things done.
I'm sure Congressman Sensenbrenner is a good man, a nice man, but at the end of the day, he's also a representative of Republican leadership that had its chance between 01 and 07 and got nothing done.
Their campaigns share a website, office, and even staff in what the two candidates believe is politics the way it should be.
You're breaking the rules. This isn't how it's done.
This isn't how it's done now. It's how it used to be done.
When Jim is in Washington or when I'm in Washington, we are going to go there and be part of bringing solutions to the country.
The candidates are both Concordia University professors who find time away from work to meet with voters who are often curious about the combined campaign.
But I like what they're doing. We'll see how it plays out. It's interesting.
And the debate tonight is where?
They also hold frequent debates throughout the district.
And the one Wednesday night, I'm sensing was probably a little bit more of a Jeff crowd. I think tonight I might have more of
like
a Jim crowd.
Yeah, I like that
crowd. Right.
But they're not exactly running in the same race yet. Burkey will first face off with Congressman Sensenbrenner in the Republican primary.
Do you support Jim in the primary?
Oh, certainly, certainly. What we're trying to do here and what we intend to do successfully is run on ideas, run on concepts that will take one of us, Jim or me, to Washington.
If you don't win in the primary, will you support him? Will you cross party lines and support a Democrat?
I haven't thought about it. I'm going to win. I'm planning on winning.
But even this tag team effort has its work cut out for it. Through 15 congressional races, Sensenbrenner is undefeated.
They're fighting in a district right now where Jim Sensenbrenner has held sway for 30 years. It's going to be virtually impossible to knock Jim Sensenbrenner off.
But these two friends believe they may have the right approach to accomplish the impossible.
Can you imagine what's going to happen around the country? When this campaign works and we knock off one of the most powerful congressmen in the House of Representatives, we're going to see copycat campaigns like this all across the country.
Of course, money is a key issue in this race, but in this case, the two candidates are actually waiting for a ruling from the Federal Election Commission to determine whether they can merge their two separate campaign funds. It's just one of the unanswered questions in a campaign that may be breaking new ground in many ways. In Cedarburg, I'm Kent Wainscott, WISN 12 News.